Greetings, everyone. Today I'm going to talk about the various terms that we use in the hotel industry. Okay, so once you start working in hotels, you need to know various terms, the main terminologies that we use in the hotel industry. Okay, so in housekeeping, we have terms like amenities. So if you have heard me talking about amenities in the other lectures that I have given earlier. Okay, so amenities are the things that the supplies of the hotel that is given to the guest. Okay, that is in a complimentary basis. That is to make the stay of the guest convenient and with no extra cost for the guest. Okay, so the next one is the back office. This is the section of the department of housekeeping, like the laundry and the florist. Okay, so this is the back side of the hotel, which these departments, they do not come directly in contact with the guest. So as room attendants, you go to the rooms and then you are interacting with the guest. Okay, so the laundry people, they will not go up to the rooms and then talk with the guest. So they are known as the back office. The business kit. So when you come across the word business kit, this is the supplies that we offer to the guest. Like you have a guest who come for business purposes, okay? So that way, like the files, the pens, whatever they require, the business kit, okay? We present to them. That is, a kit consists of basic business supplies such as file, paper, clips, pins, rubber band, glue stick, etc. for emergency purposes, that is for the guest. This is all complimentary. Okay, so the next is the bath tat or the bath mat, that is used in the when you take shower and then you come out of the shower area, you need a bath mat, bath tat in front, so that you place your feet first there and then you make it dry. Okay, so a mat used for wiping feet after taking bath, a bath tat. Clear rooms. Okay, so clear rooms means rooms that are already cleaned and then ready for sale to the next guest. Okay, the crib rate. The crib rate is a type of room that is like a children below 2 years, the rates are such that when the children are below 12 years, okay, this is the day rate or day rate or half rate. So a room that is the price of the room goes to half rate or day rate. The next is the castor wheels. These wheels are the wheels that you find on trolleys, okay, so that the movement of the trolley is maneuverable. Okay, and the next is the departure rooms. Okay, the departure rooms are the rooms to be vacant for another guest. Okay, so departure rooms, when the guests are going to check out and the rooms become vacant. Okay, that is like departure rooms. D&D card. This is known as the do not disturb card, which is hung on the door knob. If you find a small card sometimes on the door knob, that is the D&D card. Okay, so you can just lift and then I will show you later during the practicals. Okay, but then these days, like mostly they do not use D&D cards because Everything is like a switch. Okay, so once there is a light, like the red light is on, that means do not disturb. So many things like you have to keep knowing, because technologies are such, it's like changing every now and then, right? Okay, the next is the disposable bag. Okay, these are like a bag, a paper bag that is kept near the toilets, okay, the WC area, where you can throw your sanitary pads and then the tissue papers, napkin papers, everything. Okay, so what is deep cleaning? This is the thorough cleaning of the guest rooms and the public area everywhere, like the housekeeping departments. Every time they like it's like spring cleaning. Sometimes you do it weekly, monthly, like that. Okay, so you do it deep cleaning. You do it thoroughly. Okay, discrepancy report. This is the discrepancy report is the report which the housekeeping department, they make this report. Okay, so discrepancy, what do you mean by discrepancy? So sometimes the front office puts the guest, like they are you know, the they keep the guest as occupied, the status of the guest is occupied. And then in the housekeeping report, it so happens that the room is vacant. So this is a discrepancy, right? Okay, the next one is the elevator. This is the lift in the hotel. So there are lifts for the guests separately and there are lifts for the workers separately. Elevator. Executive floor, okay, a floor in the hotel which offers world-class service. Executive, as the name indicates, is you give the world-class service, like the president, like the floor which has presidential suite, Emery suite, you know, suite rooms, ambassador rooms. So the floor is the executive floor. Emergency key. So what is an emergency key? This is the key that unlocks, this has another name as well. Okay, so it can unlock double locked rooms as well, right? So emergency key, this is usually kept by the security. It's not mentioned here in the notes, but then I'm telling you, later I will show you as well. Okay, when they are double locked, also referred as grand master key. So emergency key is also known as the grand master key. The next is the floor key, a key that opens all the guest rooms in one particular floor. So this is carried by the room attendants whenever they go to a certain floor, like the first floor, second floor, third floor, like that, you know. So one floor, this key opens only the guest rooms that are situated in one floor. That this is given only to the room attendants because they will be doing the cleaning process there. Okay, so as I'm talking about the keys, let me talk about the master key as well. Okay, this master key is the key that opens only when the door is single locked. Okay, so there's a difference between the emergency key, floor key, and the master key. And the master key, it unlocks a door in a hotel which have single lock only. The next is the mattress protector. So what comes to your mind when you talk about the mattress protector? So this is something, this is a mattress that is placed above the mattress. Okay, so that there is no, there is no stains that will affect whenever like you spill, if the guest spills water, whatever, the main mattress will be protected, okay, because of the mattress protector. Okay, meter. This is the corner fold of a bed sheet, okay. This one I would like to show you when we do the practicals, because if the meter is not even, then you will have a very funny looking bed. Okay, when you are making the bed, you need to have proper lengthwise meter. Okay, the next is the napery. This is it usually refers to the table linens. This is mostly used in the room service area, okay, in the restaurants, all the, so napery, the napkins. Okay, so when there is a status like OOO in of the room, that is out of order. When there is any room that has to undergo maintenance, and then or any rooms that has to be deep cleaned, we usually put the room OOO, that is out of order. Okay, so the next is the room service. Okay, this is a section in housekeeping which is actually tied up with the F&B department as well, because this is the room service. They supply food and beverage to the guest in the rooms like 24 hours. Okay, so that way the guests will get their food anytime of the hour, and then our housekeeping is not really indulged in that, okay, in that process. Okay, what is a room status? There are various kinds of room status, okay. So let me read this out. Current position of a guest room, whether vacant, vacant dirty, vacant clean. Okay, so these are the things you have to understand. What is vacant? Vacant is empty room. Okay, so vacant dirty. So you don't write vacant dirty. If you find a room vacant dirty, you don't write vacant dirty. You write VD. Okay, so similarly, like vacant clean, you don't write vacant clean, you write BC. Okay, so these are the things you have to understand. And what is this? I think it's all in your minds, like a sewing kit. You know that you have all the sewing supplies, like the needle, the thread, everything. Like these things also I have with me, which I will show you in the practicals. Okay. Shoe mitts. What are shoe mitts? This is also one of the amenities that we provide for the guest, because they need this whenever they are going for a party or any business purposes. They need their shoes shining, right? So this is, shoe mitts are used by the guest to shine their shoes. Okay, shower cap. As you all know, I'm sure you all must be knowing, it's a plastic cap that when you take shower, it doesn't make your hair feel wet. Okay, so you wear a shower cap during your shower time, and then you take shower. Okay, and what is the turn down service? This is very important, because this is the evening service that you give to the guest. During turn down, what do? The first thing that you do is close the curtains, okay, put up the lights, and then you check whether all the amenities are there, like if the water bottles are there, okay, and then if the guests are there, you ask them like if they're comfortable, if they need anything, okay. So this is the turndown service. Upholstery. These are like linens or fabrics that are usually used to make chair covers, sofa covers. Sometimes these upholstery is used for curtains as well, so that the drapes are very neat and clean. Valet or the runner. Okay, so what is a valet? These people are runners from the laundry. They collect all the linen and all the clothes of the guest, and then they go to the rooms and then they give it back. Okay, it's all pressed, neatly packed, and then given to the guest. Okay, so this one is very important. So what is WC? This is the water closet area in the bathroom section. Okay, so whenever you are cleaning, and then if your executive housekeeper just steps in and then say, let me check the WC area. So what is WC area? Show me the WC area. Okay, so you have to know like what section is called the WC area. This is actually the European term for the toilet bowl and flush. Okay, so many more terminologies coming up. These are the basic ones, like usually, because when you work in a hotel, you have to learn all the hotel industry languages. You have to talk in hotel terms. Okay, so these things you have to keep in mind. This much for today. So I will be coming up with more terminologies, and then like I promised you, in practicals I'm going to show a lot of things that are related to housekeeping. Okay, till then, thank you very much and have a safe day.